Hello, my darlings. Let's get straight into today's collective. Let's see what the message is for today. What's the message for today's collective? What's the collective message today? What's the collective message? Release your ex. The time has come to clear your energy. Mm-mm-mm. Who's holding on to the ex? Oh, we got, okay, we got a couple. Express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. Let go of control issues. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. And then we've, chemistry. There's a strong magnetic attraction. Somebody's out here feeling like this could be the one. This could be an everlasting love. Let's see. Let's get some clarity here. Give me a couple of cards for the chemistry. We've got you sparked my interest. I'm not ready to face you. What? Why not? Let's see. You've illuminated my thoughts and mind. Okay. So I'm going to scoot these over so y'all can see them. I'm going to say, I'm hoping this is not an ex. I think that this is the opposite. I think that this is somebody wanting to come towards you, and maybe they're trying to clear their ex from their energy field, but they feel like they're not ready yet. However, I do think that this is somebody who you have... charming you off your feet. I don't know, y'all. I don't know, because then we got this one over here of revisiting my past. What the hell? We'll see. We'll see. Because this is somebody who definitely wants to charm you off your feet. Let's hope it's new and that they're trying to release their ex while you are trying to release yours. But you've definitely caught somebody's interest here. And yet they don't feel ready. They don't feel ready yet to face you. Let's start with these. Okay. We're gonna be looking at the chemistry card. Clarify, you've sparked my interest. What's going on here? We've got the Three of Cups, the Death card. Let's get one more. The Four of Cups. Look at the Queen of Pentacles in here, though. She's sexy as fuck. I feel like this is somebody who looks at you like your marriage material. And for some of you, you could be the opposite, right? You could be the one looking at this person like they are marriage material. You'll know. You'll know, because this is somebody you are very, very attracted to. But this is somebody who does not want to be putting you in a third party. So with the Death card, they're working hard to make sure that it's over. So if their ex is trying to come back into their life, they are like, nope, 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 nope. Four of Cups, they're pushing them away. Because their interest is in you. Okay. Clarify, I'm not ready to face you yet, though. What's going on with this one? Because I will say, with the Four of Cups and the Three of Cups making the Seven of Cups, whoever this is has a lot of options. But it's you they want, but they're not ready yet. Let's see. Clarify, I'm not ready to face you. The fuck? Okay. Clarify, I'm not ready to face you. King of Wands. Clarify, I'm not ready to face you. Wow. Okay, guys. Okay. All right. Unfortunately, this is not new love. This is spirit telling you to get rid of your ex, because you and your ex have a lot of chemistry. And they see you as the one they want to be with. But I think that once upon a time, they rejected you with the Four of Cups. With the Five of Swords, they might have even... they tortured you in some way. They were... they did something where they knew it was going to hurt you, and they did it anyway. With the King of Wands, it's maybe because you hurt their ego. And the Ten of Swords, see, in this Ten of Swords, the swords are coming at her where she's facing them. This is not a stabbing in the back. This was stabbing her face on. So it means you're fully aware, whoever this story is going to resonate with, you're fully aware that this person knew that they were hurting you, and they did it anyway. Whatever it is that happened. With Ace of Swords, it's saying I'm not ready to face you, and yet we have the Ace of Swords. They are going to reach out, but they might not want to address this. They don't want to talk about how they hurt you. They want to focus on the chemistry. They want to focus on the fact that now you've sparked their interest. So this might have been somebody who rejected you. Might have been somebody who made you feel like you weren't enough. And now they're like, okay, you know what? We don't have to talk about the past. Let's just talk about how attractive I find you now. Because they feel like you've changed the way that they think about some things. Oh, how nice. How nice is that? Isn't that a treat? Clarify, release your ex. Give me a couple of cards to release your ex. Coming out of hiding. And there it is again. You've illuminated my thoughts and minds. Okay. Pure intentions. Oh, really? Changing my perspective. Oh, hidden agenda. Oh, they want to meet up with you. Wow. Submit yourself to me and hiding you from a third party. I don't know why pure intentions comes out, because clearly their intentions are not pure. They might act like they are. Maybe they're in the process of releasing an ex, and that's why they're like, well, now I'm ready to, you know, I'm ready to be with you because I'm letting go of an ex. But spirit is telling you to let go of this person. If this is someone that you have not had a contact with, they're about to pop up. Now, I don't know if they're about to pop up in physical form. They might pop up like you get a text from them. But they're going to literally be sitting here telling you that you have changed the way they think about things. You've illuminated their thoughts, their mind. You make them... this card makes me... it's giving the impression of you make me want to be a better person. You make me want to do better. But the hidden agenda is they're all this sweet talk here. Because they want to meet up with you. They want to have you under their... well, first of all, they might have you under their body. With this energy. But they also want to have you under their control. Because submission is more... it's not just physical, it's psychological. But you're going to be hidden from a third party. Yeah, and I think spirit's like, yeah, you need... the time has come. You need to let this person go. Clarify coming out of hiding. Seven of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles. Ooh, I just moved those cards. And the Eight of Cups. The Ace of Cups. So, this is somebody who's coming in, letting you know how much you mean to them. Letting you know how they see you as worthy of investment, how they want to build with you. I've got the Seven and the Three of Pentacles, which is the Ten. They want to be stable with you. They want to build a life with you. Eight of Cups. They don't want you to walk away anymore. That's what we could have started with. Because I think that that's the most important part. They're going to come at you like they've got all these pure intentions. They're going to express themselves to you. Make romantic gestures. If I come across a little mocking, that's probably because I am mocking it. Because this is not, if they're still hiding you from a third party, this is not the gesture they think it is. They're going to tell you, coming out of hiding makes me think that they're going to tell you something they didn't tell you before. Especially because we also have express your love. Maybe they never told you how much they care before. And that's good. They're hoping that makes an impact on you because it's something they hadn't shared with you before. Pure intentions. Honestly, I've got to mention the fact that when this card comes out, it makes me think that this person, it's not like they're coming forward to hurt you. Let me put it that way. I think that this is somebody who is self-centered, but they don't know or they're not aware that they're being self-centered. Because honestly, people who are self-centered, it's like natural to them. They think of themselves. And hopefully, you see them as such a gift that you'll think of them too. Clarify, you've illuminated my thoughts and mind. I don't think they're coming forward to hurt you, like on purpose. We've got the Knight of Wands, the Two of Swords. Clarify, you've illuminated my thoughts and mind. And the Six of Cups. Really? Really? We've got it on our hands? Oh boy. I'm not sure how to take this card, honestly, because this is it, clear as day. Ace of Swords, Queen of Cups. Okay. If you have water energy, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, or maybe you just know how to love this way, I think that this was somebody who used to act in a way that was lacking a lot of integrity before. And in a way, they're still doing it because if they're still coming forth trying to hide you from someone else, they're still acting in a way that's not in accordance with integrity. But I feel like they're going to be a lot more honest with you about what they're doing. I'm not encouraging you to do this. I'm going to be fair and explain what I'm feeling from this person. Because it's not like I think that they're coming forward with the intention of hurting you. I don't think that, no. Do I think they'll hurt you? Yes, not intentionally, though. Knight of Wands. Because like I said, this is, look, King of Wands, Knight of Wands. This is somebody who thinks of themselves. And it's quite natural for them to think of themselves. So they may have grown up in an environment where if they didn't think of themselves, nobody would think of them. So now it became secondhand nature. It's second nature. Secondhand nature. It's second nature for them to think of themselves and everyone else after, if at all. With the Two of Swords, I don't think that they see this. With the Two of Swords, they're blind to this part of themselves. All they know is that they feel a connection to you and they want you. That's what they know. And so as far as they're aware, their intentions are pure because they're not coming forth with the intention of hurting you. In fact, they feel like, well, no, because I want to tell you how much I care about you. I want to tell you what you mean to me. I want to not be guarded anymore with you. I just don't know if this is the right connection for you, if you know what I'm saying. Clarify, express your love. Let's see. Give me a couple of cards for express your love. You and I against the world. And I've heard rumors about you. I'm not sure what to believe. But things are heating up. Holding on to baggage. Your sex appeal draws me in. Clouded by confusion. Hiding true feelings. I think that this is somebody who's confused, honestly. They're not sure if they're lusting after you or if they love you. So it's almost like they're, in a way, they're trying to figure that out. So if they are very lusty towards you, it's because I think there's a piece of them that's curious about maybe I just need to fuck this person out of my system. Like, if it's lust and I sleep with them and it goes away, then that's all it was. It was lust. But if I sleep with them and it intensifies, then that's love. Because this might be somebody who doesn't know how to tell the difference. They're not a King of Cups. They're not emotion. I don't think that they're very emotionally intelligent. I think that they're intelligent in how to get what they want, but they might not know how to tell the difference between love and infatuation. Let me put it that way. Clarify you and I against the world. So that's why they want to come in heating things up, because that's the only way they'll be able to tell if this is lust or love. Clarify you and I against the world. The Hermit, the Hanged Man, and the Tower. With the Justice card. The Nine of Swords, the Ace of Pentacles, the Three of Wands. Whatever they're coming forward with, we've got the Tower. They're going to shock you in some way. But whatever they're going to tell you, it's also going to put you in a lot of anxiety. But with the Justice card, they feel like they're doing the right thing. So again, I'm not saying that they're intentionally coming forward to hurt you. They feel like they're doing the right thing. We had the Ace of Swords show up twice. They're going to tell you some sort of truth that they feel is setting things right, but in some way, it's really going to shock you. In fact, with the Hermit, you may need some time to think about this. Give me one second. Yeah, you may need some time to think about this, because you're sitting here like, whoa, this is a lot. It's a lot. But it's clarifying the you and I against the world. And maybe that's the part that you feel like it's a lot. Because how, I don't understand how this is going to happen when they're hiding you from a third party. That's what I don't understand. So it could be that they're going to explain some sort of plan that they have. Whatever it is they're going to explain, it's going to knock you off your feet. Like, you're what? And with the Hermit, you're going to need a lot of alone time here. You're going to be in this energy of like, I need to think about this. I need to think about this, because it is, I'm sorry. If y'all can hear extra noise out there, there's people in the house and they're being loud. So my bad. But yeah, this is some sort of arrangement, maybe, with the Justice card. I don't know if this goes with the other collective. It might be. Because it's like, this puts you all in your head and you're sitting here like, I don't know. Clarified, I've heard rumors about you. I'm not sure what to believe. Got the Queen of Cups. See, I'm going to tell you right now, I don't like this energy. Because it makes me feel like somebody around them may have influenced their perception of you. And I hate that. I have a Scorpio Mercury. So to me, you should already know what I'm capable of or not. The Wheel of Fortune. In fact, to me, that's how people show loyalty. When they know, like, no, Rose would never do that. Seven of Swords. That's not who Rose is. And if you're similar, well, that could be a problem. Four of Swords. Because again, this is coming from the energy of trying to heal things. This is like, okay, we're trying to fix it. I'm putting energy into trying to fix things. They don't want to lose you. Four of Pentacles, they're trying to hold on to you. Coming in as Emperor energy, Page of Pentacles. See, Page of Pentacles and Knight of Pentacles. So they want to give you something. Whatever it is they want to give you, they think like that should hold you. Because what they want is for you to love them. That's what they want. With the Wheel of Fortune, they feel like this is destiny. They want to move away. Whatever rumors they've listened to that have allowed them to skew their perception, they might not tell you about that. Seven of Swords. That part they might hide. Because, of course, like what I just mentioned, right? They don't want you to know that they thought you were not a good person in some way because of what other people told them. So, I don't know. This is confusing because I feel like in some ways they're going to tell you the truth, but okay, this is what I'm getting. Now that I started processing that, I was like, they're going to tell you the truth, but they're going to hide some things. They are going to tell you half-truths in the sense that what they tell you is going to be the truth, but it doesn't mean it's all the truth. It doesn't mean that it's everything that happened. There's pieces they're still going to hide, like this. Like the fact that somebody else influenced the way they saw you, they don't want you to know about that. Because that could kind of kill the mood, you know? Then things might not get romantic after all. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's see. Let go of control issues. Let's see. We've got your sex appeal, trust me. Oh, that card already twice. Let's see. One more for let go of control issues. Allow the situation to unfold naturally. I want to grow old with you. This is where they don't know which one of these it is with you. They're not sure if they just find you so sexy that they want to grow old with you, or if they truly want to grow old with you. They're not sure. See. Yeah, I feel like this is somebody who has very sexual thoughts. This might be the only way that they know how to express affection, honestly. So that could be another problem. If you're the type of person that you need to communicate, I have a feeling this person struggles communicating. Because all I've seen so far is a lot of sexual energy. I don't think that they know how to express themselves. Look, hiding you from a third party. They're still involved with someone else. I'm afraid to let you see the real me, barricading you out, but they still have pure intentions. Okay. I can't offer you much, but I want to give you all I can. Oh, Lord. I think that this is connected to the other collective. And for you guys who are always asking, well, where's the other collective? You either have to subscribe to Facebook, but I would prefer y'all go to Patreon because that's where I'm transferring over, especially starting November 25th. Everything will be over there. Yeah, I have a feeling this is somebody who really struggles with expressing. That's why to them, them coming in telling you how they feel, that might be a big deal for them. Because maybe they're not the type that says that type of thing. But you're just so damn sexy that they've got to come and tell you something, otherwise you won't open up. I feel like this is what they're going to tell you. They're going to tell you to stop trying to control the situation. Stop asking them for specific things. Just let the situation unfold naturally. Just let things develop. Why be so strict about how it needs to develop? Clarify your sex appeal draws me in. Okay, Ten of Wands, and this one flipped over. Y'all saw that. Let's see. Ten of Cups reversed. Clarify your sex appeal draws me in. And the Five of Wands. Ooh. The Four of Swords. Look, the sexual tension is strong, y'all. It is strong to the point where they don't know. They don't know what they have to do to fix this. Because ultimately, the sexual tension, which is the Five of Wands, is so strong that they're not happy without, it's like they just want to taste you. You know what I'm saying? Look at this card. They want to taste that booty. I mean, not literally. Well, maybe not. I'm not judging. But with the Ten of Wands here, it's become a burden to them. I think that the fantasies that they have concerning you are literally overwhelming them. That's why they're coming in trying to, how do I put this? Trying to seduce you, really, is what they're trying to do. I don't see this being the love of a lifetime. I really don't. There's a love of attraction. There's a lot of chemistry. I just don't think that this is authentic, this part here. Let's see. Oh, I moved the other card too. All right, let's see. Clarify, I want to grow old with you. We've got the Strength card, the Five of Cups. Clarify, I want to grow old with you. And the Six of Pentacles. The Queen of Pentacles. See, you're showing up, the feminine is showing up with Queen of Pentacles energy. Queen of Cups energy. Which king have they shown up with? King of Wands. Those are not matching energies. Let's see, what else did they show up as? They showed up as a Knight of Wands. They've shown up as a King of Wands, Knight of Wands. And you've shown up as Queen of Pentacles, Queen of Cups. They know that if they seduce you the right way, you will be devoted to them. You will submit to them. You will be under their control. They want to almost like hypnotize you. Now, this is saying be careful, because whatever agreement you get into, look at this. This is signing a deal with the devil. I think you'd end up regretting it, because they'd give you, look at this, they'd give you breadcrumbs. You would get breadcrumbed. Because this is not your match. This is not somebody, they're not coming in as a King of Pentacles. They're not coming in as a King of Cups. You don't have their heart. You don't have their devotion. You have their lust. They're attracted to you. But this would be signing a deal with the devil. It's up to you if you submit or not. Okay, so I think that this is your advice. The time has come to clear your energy. Release your ex. Let this person go. Catch and release, y'all. Catch and release. Okay. All right, that's what I got for you. I hope that this gave you some clarity and guidance. As usual, I look forward to feedback. Talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.